We shall understand some important definitions like atomic number, atomic mass, isotopes, isobar, isoton, and isoelectronic species. Now, atomic number and atomic mass. First, we understand what is atomic mass. Before we study about atomic mass, we shall understand atomic number. Atomic number is denoted by symbol Z, and number of protons. Number of protons present in atom or number of electrons present in an atom is known as atomic number Z. Now, atomic mass number, or simply say atomic mass is denoted by capital A, and that is the total number of proton and neutron is known as atomic mass number. Atomic mass number, which is denoted by A. Now, if we mention any element, say X, here we will write Z and here we will write A. So, Z is said to be atomic number and A is said to be atomic mass or atomic mass number. Take example, if we write sodium metal 11Na23, then 11 is said to be either number of electrons or number of protons, and that is said to be atomic number. And 23 is known as atomic mass number. This is said to be atomic mass number. Now, take some more example to understand this atomic mass and atomic number. When we write 16, sulfur atomic number is 16, 32, 2 minus. How to calculate number of electrons, number of protons, and number of neutrons present in this species? 16 is number of protons. Number of protons. Or we can say number of electrons. But here the species is negative ion. Therefore, to find out number of electrons, number of electrons, 16 plus 2, that is total 18 electrons, because it is negative ion. Now for neutron, we can find out neutron by, just remember, when atomic mass number is subtracted from atomic number only, that is 32 minus 16, we will get 16, that is number of neutron. So we can say, for finding number of neutron, we can say न्यूट्रॉन इज इक्वल टू ए माइनस जेड, इट मीन्स दैट जेड इज सब्ट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम ए, मीन्स एटॉमिक नंबर, एटॉमिक नंबर इज रिमूव्ड और सब्ट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम एटॉमिक मास नंबर. So we will get the number of neutrons. Another example of sodium, but it is positive ion. So 11 is the number of protons, number of protons. 23 is total number of protons plus neutrons. Electrons, here it is 11 number, but because of positive sign, total number of electrons we can say 11 minus 1, that is equal to 10. Now as I mentioned, how to find out neutron? Neutron is equal to A minus Z. Neutron is equal to A minus Z. So here in this particular case, 23 minus 11, we will get 12. So once more, remember, to find out neutron, we have to apply A minus Z formula. Not Z minus A, but A minus Z formula. Now, total of protons and neutrons is said to be nucleons. Now we study isotopes. What do you mean by isotope? Take example of hydrogen, 1H1, 1D2 and 1T3. These are the isotopes of hydrogen, in which we can see the atomic number is the same. Here we can see in every species atomic number is the same. But atomic mass number, or simply say atomic mass, is different. Therefore, these are said to be isotopes of each other. 1H1, simple hydrogen, deuterium and tritium, they are said to be isotopes of each other. Same way, we can study other isotopes of oxygen, uranium, carbon, etc. But we have to remember, for isotopes, atomic number is the same, but atomic mass number is different. Here we can find out number of neutron in all the three species. As in the first case, 1H1, there is no neutron present, because when we do N is equal to A minus J, 1 minus 1, we will get 0. In the second case, that is deuterium, 1D2, number of neutron is equal to, again, formula A minus Z, we will get 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. And in tritium, we will get number of neutron is equal to 3 minus 1, that is 2. So, hydrogen, deuterium and tritium are isotopes of each other. Now, isobar. Isobar, take example of argon and calcium. Here it is obvious that different atomic number is different. But atomic mass number is the same. So from this we can define that the species in which atomic number is different but atomic mass number is the same, then they are said to be isobar to each other. Another example, 6C14 and 7N14, that is carbon, one of the isotope of carbon, and this is nitrogen. 6 and 7 means different atomic number. Different atomic number, but same atomic mass number. So we can say that carbon and nitrogen, these two isotopes of carbon and nitrogen are also the case of isobar. Now isotones. The species in which number of neutrons are same, the species in which number of neutrons are same are known as isotones. Take example, 6C14, one of the isotope of carbon, 7N15 and 8O16. Let us study whether they are isotones or not. So here we can see number of neutrons in carbon, 14 minus 6, that is 8. In nitrogen, for carbon, for nitrogen, number of neutron is equal to 15 minus 7, that is also 8. And for oxygen, N is equal to 15 minus 7 is equal to 8. And for oxygen also, N is equal to 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. So these are said to be isotones to each other. Now we study isoelectronic. What do you mean by isoelectronic species? Take example of Na plus ion and neon Ne and fluorine F minus. Na plus having 10 electrons. Na plus is having 10 electrons. Actual atomic number of sodium is 11. But it is Na plus. It means it has lost one electron. So total number of electrons present in sodium plus ion is 10 electrons. In neon there are 10 electrons. And in F minus, actually 9 electrons are present in fluorine, but because of it is F minus ion, 1 electron will be added and we will get 10 electrons. So Na plus, Ne and F minus are said to be isoelectronic species. We have come to know that fundamental particles present in an atom are proton, neutron and electron. We shall study now about models, or simply we can say atomic models. First we will study atomic model proposed by J.J. Thomson. Thomson's atomic model. It is also known as Thomson's atomic model, in which according to Thomson, an atom is spherical and radius of atom (10⁻¹⁰ meter. Now electrons are unevenly distributed in this positive sphere, so this model is compared with, or we can say few names were given to this model like Plum-Pudding model, Raisin-Pudding model or Watermelon model. Because when we give the name, say suppose Watermelon model, then seeds present in watermelon are considered like electron. Same way, Raisin pudding model, if we compare Thomson model of atomic model is compared with Raisin pudding model, then we can say raisins or simply say kismis are said to be like electron. This model, according to this model, we can say that atomic mass is distributed in whole atom. Atomic mass is distributed throughout the atom, or we simply we can say whole atom. But after the discovery or after the experiment of Rutherford experiment of alpha scattering, this model could not stay properly, because this could explain only about the positive sphere in which electrons are embedded like seed present in watermelon, that is electrons. But it failed when Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment was carried out. So another model we have to study is Rutherford alpha scattering model. Now we study another model, that is Rutherford atomic model. This model is also known as nuclear model. Rutherford took gold foil of 10⁻⁴ mm size. Gold foil is of 10⁻⁴ mm and bombarded alpha particles whose formula is 2He4 with plus 2 charge. So when alpha particles were bombarded on this thin gold foil, the experiment said, we can understand, this we can say source of alpha particle, this is a lead plate, and here we have gold foil. And circular screen of zinc sulfide was kept behind gold foil. Now we can say that maximum flash was found at this position, and here we can say minimum this side or this side, we can say minimum place was found on this observation. By drawing an atom structure, we can understand different observations. If we draw gold foil to be spherical form, then most of the alpha particles have been passed from one side to another side. Few deflected at low angle and few deflected at more angle. But we can see that maximum alpha particles remain like undeflected. Means most of the alpha particles have been passed from one side to another side. And we can see that very few or only some of the particles were deflected at different angles. From this, what observations and conclusion we can derive? Let's study that. Number one, maximum alpha particles were passed from one side to other side. From this, what can be concluded? That maximum of atom is empty. First observation, we can study that maximum portion of an atom is empty. Second, some alpha particles deflected at an angle. So from this we can say that in the nucleus or core region, or we can say simply in the core region, there must be positively charged nucleus present. And third observation, very few, nearly we can say out of 20,000, only one deflected at an angle nearly 180. So from this we can conclude that the core region must be very small. So these are the observations and conclusions possible from Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment. Now he defined nucleus orbit according to Rutherford's model, nuclear model. Nucleus means what? The core region of an atom which is positively charged is known as nucleus. In nucleus, protons and neutrons are found together. Now, 10^-10 मीटर इज द रेडियस ऑफ एन एटम. 10^-10 मीटर इज द रेडियस ऑफ एन एटम एंड 10^-15 मीटर इज द रेडियस ऑफ न्यूक्लियस. सो ऑन कंपेयरिंग दिस वी कैन से न्यूक्लियस ऑफ एन एटम इज 10^5 टाइम्स स्मॉलर देन फुल एटम और होल एटम. न्यूक्लियस ऑफ एन एटम इज 10^5 टाइम्स स्मॉलर देन होल एटम. वी कैन से होल एटम. सो फ्रॉम दिस स्टडी ऑल्सो वी कैन से दैट न्यूक्लियस इज वेरी वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज. नाउ अनदर थिंग, दैट इज एक्स्ट्रा न्यूक्लियर पार्ट. एक्स्ट्रा न्यूक्लियर पार्ट इन विच इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विथ नेगेटिव चार्ज कॉन्स्टेंटली मूविंग. इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विथ नेगेटिव चार्ज कॉन्स्टेंटली मूविंग अराउंड न्यूक्लियस इज नॉन एज ऑर्बिट. सो दिस पाथ इन विच इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विथ नेगेटिव चार्ज कॉन्स्टेंटली मूविंग अराउंड न्यूक्लियस दैट पाथ इज सेड टू बी ऑर्बिट. न्यूक्लियस एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर अट्रैक्टेड टूवर्ड्स ईच अदर बाय इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक फोर्स. बट Rutherford model made some drawbacks, so we study the drawbacks of Rutherford's nuclear model. Drawback of Rutherford nuclear model. When we compare Rutherford models with solar family, then in the solar family, planets are considered as electrons and the sun is considered to be nucleus. As planets revolve around the sun, same way electrons revolve around the nucleus. That is why we can compare this with solar family. Now, between electrons and nucleus, the force existing is Coulombic force, which is denoted by F is equal to Q1 Q2 upon R square, where Q1 and Q2 are charges and R is the distance between these two charges. Same way, mathematically it is equivalent to gravitational force. F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square. Here M1 and M2 at masses of the object and r is the distance between the objects, between the objects. Now another fact, planets revolve around the sun, same way electrons also revolve around the nucleus, but electron is a charged particle. Electron is charged particle, so when it rotates around the nucleus, it must be accelerated. And any accelerated charged particle must emit radiation. That is according to Maxwell theory of electromagnetism. Maxwell theory of electromagnetism, we can say any accelerated charged particle must emit radiation. Now, this is possible because of the motion of electron around the nucleus. Once more, any accelerated charged particle must emit radiation, that is from the theory of Maxwell, electromagnetic theory of Maxwell. Motion of electron around the nucleus is possible, and because of that, radiations are also emitted. Now, because of this, orbit shrink. Orbit must be shrink. And one calculation says that in 10 raised to minus 8 second time, 10 raised to minus 8 second, electron can enter to nucleus. But in reality, this is not possible. Electron can never enter into the nucleus. So that is why we can say there are some drawbacks of Rutherford nuclear model. One more difficulty in his model is it cannot show the stability of atom. Also we can say that number of electrons arranged around the nucleus cannot be understood from Rutherford nuclear model, and that is why we can say these are some drawbacks of Rutherford nuclear model.